Hello there, and welcome to Ms. Red Nebula's Planko Tips, Theme Maker's Toolkit Edition. This tutorial will cover how to make a good icon for your Theme Maker's Toolkit items. The software used in this tutorial includes the free 3D program Blender, the snipping tool that comes with Windows, and how to save the icon using either the free graphics program GIMP or using Photoshop. To start with, open up your model in Blender. Go to the World tab with the icon that looks like a planet. Under Surface, click on the box next to Color and change this to be completely white. Change your view to Rendered. You'll want to have your texture on your model, but in most cases you don't need to worry about details like normal mapping, roughness, or lighting. Most of that detail will disappear at small size. If your model uses flexi colors, create a texture that most closely matches the default flexi colors you're using in-game. You won't upload this to the TMT with your model, it's only for use in Blender, so make sure it's not in the folder with the files you intend to upload. Left-click to reposition the 3D cursor somewhere out of view. Then zoom in and position your model so it'll make a good icon image. Here are a couple tips. The icon will be square, so try to make your model take up as much of a square space as possible. The picture will be small, so keep the silhouette of your object in mind to make it clear what it is even at a tiny size. Open the snipping tool. This handy tool comes default with Windows. You can search for it in the Start menu search bar if you need to. If it's not already, change the mode dropdown to Rectangular Snip. Position the snipping tool window so it's out of the way. Click and drag a rectangle around your model in Blender. Don't worry if it's not a perfect square. Just make sure your whole model is in the bounds of the selection box. Click the icon that looks like two pages. This will copy the image to your computer's clipboard. There are a few qualities that make for a good icon. It should be small in size so it doesn't add unnecessary size to your file. It should have a transparent background, otherwise your object will show with a white border around it. Additionally, if you make a grid-based item, the grid won't show properly without a transparent background. Your model should not have a margin around it and can go right up to the edges of the image. A margin will be added inside of Planet Coaster. Finally, the icon must be saved with the exact file name, icon.png. I'll show you how to do this in both GIMP and Photoshop. To skip ahead to the Photoshop instructions, go to the timestamp shown on screen now. Open up GIMP. Go to the Edit menu and choose Paste to bring your screenshot into the program. To make the background transparent, choose the Select by Color tool, the icon that looks like three circles with a selection marquee around one. In the menu that appears below the tools, make sure the Feather Edges option is off and turn the threshold down to zero. Click anywhere in the white area around your model. All of the white space in the whole image will be selected. Click the Delete key and the white will disappear. The gray checkerboard pattern indicates that this part is see-through. There may be a thin white halo around your model. It won't be visible in the final icon. Go to the Select menu and choose None to deselect everything. Next, go to the Crop tool, which looks like a pair of brackets. In the menu below, click the box next to Fixed and make sure its dropdown says Aspect Ratio. In the box underneath, change it to read 1:1. This locks the tool to a perfect square. Click and drag the crop selection around your model. You want the square as close to your model as possible without cutting any of it off. You can click and drag the center of the selection to move it around, or click and drag any of the boxes in the corners to resize it if needs be. When you're happy with your selection, press Enter to finalize it. Go to the Image menu and choose Scale Image. Make sure the chain icon next to Width and Height appears whole and not broken. This locks your aspect ratio so the image stays square. Change the width to 128. The height will change too. Press Scale. Finally, most icons are not complex enough to require a full color PNG. This step is optional, but will reduce the size of your icon file. Go to the Image menu, Mode, and choose Indexed. Leave the color map option on Generate Optimum Palette. An indexed image will have up to 256 colors, but most small images don't even need that many. 16 colors is plenty for my grayscale zebra, but if you've got a colorful object, you may want to stick with 64 or higher. Experiment with the numbers if you wish. You can always undo with Ctrl Z and then try again if you're unhappy with the result. Press Convert when you're finished. To save as a PNG from GIMP, use the Export option. Go to File, Export. Click Select File Type by Extension. Scroll to find PNG image and select it. Navigate to where you wish to save your icon. It will go in the same folder as your FBX file and materials, and then export it with the file name icon.png. Just leave the options as is and click Export again. Okay, now let's do the same thing in Photoshop. I'll be repeating a couple things in case you skip the GIMP section. If you're using GIMP and want to skip the Photoshop part, jump to the timestamp shown on the screen now. Open Photoshop and click Create New. When you have an image copied to your computer's clipboard, you should get the option Clipboard as one of the available presets. Select that. Change the Background Contents option to Transparent. You may have to scroll down to see it. Click Create. Older versions of Photoshop will just have the Create New settings match the clipboard image settings by default. Go to the Edit menu and select Paste, and your image will appear. Go to the Magic Wand tool. You may not see it by default as it's under the same tool set as the Quick Selection tool. Look for an icon that looks like a brush painting a selection marquee. Click and hold the left mouse button to see the other tools in this set, and choose the one that looks like a wand. At the top of the screen, change the tolerance value to 0 and uncheck Contiguous. This allows the tool to select all instances of white space on the whole image instead of only ones connected to where you click. Click in the white background of your image to select it, and then press Delete. Now, you can see a checkerboard pattern indicating this part of the image is transparent. Go to the Select menu and choose Deselect. Next, go to the Crop tool, which, like in GIMP, looks like a pair of brackets. Click the Ratio dropdown at the top of the screen and choose the 1:1 square option. Position the square as close as possible to your model and then hit Enter to finalize the crop. To save the image, I like to use Photoshop's Save for Web tool. In older versions of Photoshop, it's just in the main File menu, but in newer versions, it's under File, Export, and says Save for Web Legacy. Change the width and height under Image Size to 128. If the chain links next to the image are toggled on, the aspect ratio will be retained and height will automatically change when you change the width. Then, in the dropdown for file types, choose PNG 8. Make sure the transparency checkbox is selected. PNG 8 only allows 256 colors, but it's a much smaller file size than PNG 24. Most small images like icons don't even need that many colors. Use the Colors dropdown, or type in a number, to test out a different number of colors. For this grayscale zebra, 16 is plenty, but if you've got a more colorful image, you may need more to make sure it looks good. Don't go too low, or it may look grainy and some colors will disappear. When you're happy with your icon, click Save. Navigate to where you wish to save your icon and save it with the file name icon.png. Now you've got an icon. It will go in the folder with your model's FBX file and materials, and needs to be part of the zip file you upload. As you can see, the in-game icon is given a nice margin automatically, doesn't have an off-color border around it, and fits in nicely with the look of the game. So that's it for this tutorial. Feel free to like or comment, and if you want random updates from my Planet Coaster exploits, subscribe! If you enjoy what I do and are interested in supporting the channel, check out my Patreon. In addition to helping me out, you can also get fun perks like sneak peeks, voting on future projects, or being the first to see new videos. A big thank you to my current patrons. That's all for now. Bye!